Oh yeah, konnichiwa, welcome back.
Ow.
That was fast. Yeah, I I forgot daylight savings time was or what is it? Are we out of it or in it now? I can't remember, but whatever. I guess my biological clock's a little bit busted today, so yeah. I did have a tab open. Okay. All right. Yeah. So since I think I mentioned it before, but since where is it? Oh, right. So since the molecular and cell bio class doesn't have an assignment that's due today or this week, I should study for physics, right? I'm not. I should, but I'm not. At least, yeah. Well, I feel like I'm forgetting a class. So let me see. I must be forgetting a class. So let me blur the screen first. Oops. How do I undo? That's not what I meant to do. Is that close enough? Okay. No, that's not close at all. It's just maybe the size a little different. I'll fix it later. All right, so I wanted to check my class schedule. Actually, I probably didn't need to blur the screen for that, but whatever. Right. Right. So there's nothing here. I don't think there's anything here. Oh, but there is. I need to join a group. But that's okay. I think we're gonna talk about that tomorrow anyway. So. That's okay. Oh, it's called me. Welcome back as well. Yeah. So yeah. So I should be good. I should be good for some more. Progress on Operation Meet Yago, and considering I basically wasted the entire day just kind of not being productive, I should be productive. Let's see, he's calling it, got a thing for my Raspberry Pi 4. Oh, cool. What'd you get? Speaking of the Raspberry Pi, I've... New case! Okay, awesome. Yeah, I was gonna say, I saw there's a new breakout board for the compute modules, right? Like, I remember seeing a new breakout board for CM4 that has like an M.2 slot and a bunch of other stuff, and I was like, man, I wish I could get one. Not really sure what I'd do with it, but it looked cool. Argon 1 V2. What is this? Oh, but I guess, are you using it as like a home theater PC-ish thing? Or are you using it as like a... Is that what you're sort of what you're using it for? I was like, what is this overkill thing? But I was like, wait, no, if you use it for like HDPC and emulation. Okay, yeah, see, that makes sense, yeah. And then the full-size HDMI is definitely... Is anyone else really annoyed that like... Well, actually, wait, as Raspberry Pi 4, I actually haven't seen the board layout. I know for like they switched to like mini HDMI or micro HDMI on one of the later models and really annoyed me. The Pi 4 uses micro. Wow, who the hell uses micro? I mean, I know why. It's so it fits on the board and you don't have to use the weird ass like vertical HDMI connector that's super like flimsy. But okay, so whatever, this is good, so you don't have to fuss with, like, a freaking micro HDMI cable. Who the hell uses micro HDMI? I mean, you know, whatever, it's, and you know, I guess it's probably more structurally sound than, again, an angled HDMI port, so, yeah. Okay, yeah, that's good. Oh, and it routes everything to the back. Oh, I see, okay, sorry, I'm looking at the video that's loud. Oh, it's got, like, a magnetic... Oh, that's cool. I always like magnets. Magnets are cool, but also in all seriousness, yeah, it's at least it's not some weird, like, just, you know, compliant clip cover thing. Yeah. Okay, yeah, that's actually really good. Yeah. How expensive is this? That's not even that expensive, you know. I mean, you know, in the grand scheme of Raspberry Pi cases. Oh, interesting. They made their own, like, you know, PCB to route the video connections and the audio. That's a totally understandable price is totally, you know, understandable. It's pretty cool. Oh yeah, and Kaz, welcome back as well. Let's see, right, so again, I'm behind schedule, but again, I'm always behind schedule, so cool story, bro, right? We're gonna go to Minato Yu's easy hair tutorial. Yeah. Well, he's got something else here. I guess we'll watch that instead. Oh, by the way, I tried to multi-stream earlier today. I don't know if anyone noticed my stream go live for very briefly. Yeah, no, my stream PC cannot handle Twitch and YouTube at the same time. It's not literally that it can't. It's more like the roundabout shit I have to do to get both of them streaming at the same time is and not, you know, instead of using like Restream or something, just is too, you know, intensive. So I've given up on that, and I think I'm just going to back up all my videos to, I think I'm just going to have streams recorded and then back them up to YouTube. I'll figure out how to do it automatically at some point, but, if you didn't know any better, you'd think it's some kind of professional micro, right, yeah, they really nailed the, well, actually, I guess it depends. Does it actually look like the product image, you know, in person? Because, you know, we have all seen, like, you know, people try to do, like, oh, this is like a brushed aluminum thing, but when you get it, it's kind of like brushed aluminum-ish plastic, and yeah, it does. Okay, so then, yeah, $25 is totally, yeah, I mean, like, a cheap plastic one's gonna run you like $10 anyway, right? You might as well. Oh, my dude, why didn't he put a warning? That's not safe. Is that safe for Twitch? I don't know if that was safe for Twitch. I'm like, dude, the title of the video is essentially like red pen isn't, like, you know, correcting a video, and he's like, and the title is, let's make hair like this, and when you look at the thumbnail, it doesn't go above the collar, so I didn't know there was nothing under the collar. Like, well, we'll see what Twitch does about it. I think the solution is to just blur my screen then. Yeah. After learning Lua in 4 hours, I now can make my Vim settings way more robust. And we'll see how Twitch feels about that. I might have to take down the video. Well, wait, then again, if Twitch, YouTube is totally fine with this video. This video was uploaded 2 days ago, so I assume. Yeah. Right, we'll speed it up because, yeah. You know, honestly, I don't know. Yeah. Does he have, like, timestamps or something? Also, is it just me, or is this totally like a Miku drawing? I know you guys only saw it briefly, but it's like, this is Miku fan art, right? Anyone else watching Quintessential Quintuplets? Is that what it's called in the US? I think it is. Okay, so first, So let's start.
So thickness, weight, and I guess spatial presence. He's saying he's looking at this fan art. He's saying it's kind of lacking. As for exactly how to change that, I think he's gonna talk about later. Then the highlight is too. Usui is what, thin? Yeah, I guess thin is too thin. And he also mentioned specifically that the highlight color chosen here was too close to the hair's base color and kind of is partially causing that. So, 'cause I guess that's a good point. Yeah, if you choose a highlight color, you want to make it very, I guess, significantly different from the hair's base color, right? Makes sense. Okay, so he says in this case he thought it was the thing as a whole was lacking shadows. Okay, so. Okay, so he's saying in this case it seemed like the characters being kind of lit from the rear, so he said he's gonna try adding shadows kind of in line with that. Okay. Okay, so he's saying that if you don't have enough shadows, it can kind of stop your highlights from being as prominent, which I guess makes sense. You want that contrast there. So I guess that's something to keep in mind as I'm working on coloring the hair here. Yeah, so basically, he's saying, that's a very easy beginner mistake, so make sure you have enough shadows for, Okay. Understandable. Understandable. Okay, so you said yeah, so at least in the case of the person who submitted the drawing, he's saying that yeah, even the highlights that he did add were kind of added very boyakeru, it's blurry, I guess. We're it's kind of very like blurred, like and I guess having a very clear what we call it, highlights can make it look better, so he said just maybe keep that in mind. Okay, so let's see what he does. So yeah, the first thing he said, yeah, put a very clear shadow in. So I guess that's what he's adding here. And it does look like he, at the end of the day, what he's doing is he's using whatever the color of the shadow will be, and then he's just using the layer's opacity to kind of adjust to what degree it shows up. So I guess that's a valid way of doing it. Okay. You know, he says such like obvious things, but like in retrospect, it's like, yeah, I wasn't really thinking about that as I was making it. So he brings up a good point. Like, for example, what he brings up here is the straight hair that comes down to the side of the head for this character, for example. The way it had initially been drawn was, you know, just like a couple big strands. But since there was no like clear shadow being used, or yeah, since it was the same color, it wasn't really clear which strand was like in the, like, you know, you could follow the hair and be like, oh yeah, that one must be the one in the front. But when you kind of just look at it wasn't really clear like which strand was like first, second, third, you know, in terms of like proximity to the eye. So like what he did, for example, is he just kind of shaded one to be like, okay, yeah, see, that's the back of one of the like the that's like that's not even a strand in the front. It's just a strand in the back that's coming forward or something. So like no shit, you'd do it like that. But at the same time, it's like, yeah, I wasn't really thinking about that, was I? So yeah, so we'll make sure to apply that. Right, yeah. So if you don't want to apply the shadow that dark, which I think I can kind of relate to, and he says, yeah, just kind of, you know, erase it a little to make it like to make like a gradation, and then just make sure it's a little bit darker at the interface between any two ambiguous like strands of hair or something. So that makes sense. That makes sense. I guess I'm just gonna speed up and go through all of them. And it looks like he has about. It looks like he does have a couple layers, and they're all using the same color. I just assume it's just with the layer opacity lower a little bit, and you overlapping multiple of those, like opaque layers. It just makes each part look a little bit darker or something. So I guess that's how he does it. Just. Yeah. Okay. So. Yeah. And he's also saying, yeah, like it's not like you're not allowed to make stuff like blurry. It's just how you make it blurry. So I guess he's gonna extrapolate. He doesn't really expand on that, actually. All he just said is like, yeah, so just, for example, with highlights, he's like, yeah, since those are one things you want to stand out really well, you know, you'd rarely blur them. But then again, he, at the same time, he just freely, you know, pretty freely blurs the shadows, I guess, because really the only parts where shadows need to be clearly defined is, well, I guess one of the situations is, for example, right here where he mentioned the interface between strands of hair or something. So I mean, I guess it's obvious information again, but you know, there's something about seeing everything in practice. Like right here, yeah, he blurs stuff to. Okay, so he even says that he'll just go ahead and do like an overall gradation across the entire, you know, like the entirety of the hair, just at the very beginning, just to, you know, based on where the light's coming from, to just kind of establish kind of a directionality to it. Okay. So I guess you'd probably start with that, and then you'd add in the really well-defined colors. I guess that's the strat then. Interesting. So he says one technique is that you can make the hair that's on the interior, or hair that's, yeah, essentially like it's the hair that's facing, that's kind of isolated from the outside, like it's interior to the, like if you got hair that's facing the outside, then you've got hair that, you know, some surface that facing the inside, right? So he's saying rather than make that dark, if you make it light, it can kind of make the overall hair just look like lighter, or I guess if you make that brighter, then you can like make the hair in terms of weight feel a little bit lighter. Okay, I've seen that done before. I didn't really ever think about quantifying it as the hair being lighter or heavier, but we'll keep that in mind as well. Okay. Yeah, so he says for applying highlights, keep in mind, I guess, directionality and volume. Right. No shit, but. But I guess, yeah, so I guess that's what you see often. I remember when I was making my color rough draft, I kind of made the quantity of the highlight consistent across the top of the head, but I guess, right, it would be a little more interesting to have it like kind of arc in, like be like have a lot at the edge of the hair, but then kind of thin out as it comes into the head. That'd probably be a little more interesting. So, and then again, he mentions here, like, you know, just pure white as a highlight color is kind of boring, so. Yeah. So then he's saying, you know, he says, you know, one thing you can do is you can make it match up with the, you know, what color would even show up if the hair color in question reflected. Like in the case of like, if you had brown hair, then it's going to reflect and be more like golden or like orange, right? So he says that can be more interesting. What is this? Looking for more music, pretty close to having enough to up to my internet radio with even more stuff. Okay. Yeah. Although, actually, I've met one repeat. I've had a song repeat once so far listening to that. I mean, granted, I'm not tuned in all the time, but I've had it repeat once, so I guess it's perfect timing. And you know, I obviously don't recognize a lot of songs, but it was the you know, that one song that you mentioned that you wanted me to translate the Japanese at the beginning, and it was about like using like it was some girl and she's talking about like an app or something, and I can't remember. The Rhythm Machine, yeah. So that it was that song. It was the song that had that stuff at the beginning. I was like, wait a sec, I recognize this. Yeah. So ironically, that's although I think that's the only one I've recall repeating. So, yeah. But anyway. Okay.
Okay. Now I see what he's getting at now. Okay, so he still applies, like, what would you call it then? Like diffuse light, I guess, probably. Yeah. Oh, the repeat thing. Right. Yeah. Yeah. No. I was just saying, like, in the entirety since you've started that server, I've only ever had that song repeat, or that repeated once, and that was the only repeat I ever got. So I was just kind of, I was like, I don't know if that means I've listened to it enough, or if I've listened to it the server enough, or if it means that. I haven't listened to it enough, or I don't know if it's too much or not enough listening to it, but I was like, ironically, that's the only one I recognize or that I can recall ever having repeated. So I say ironically because it's a song that you mentioned on stream. Well, I guess, well, that could be kind of a just an awareness thing, right? Maybe I've had songs repeat and I just didn't recognize them because I didn't know what the song was, but yeah. But anyway, yeah. So. It's on shuffle, so probably just RNG. Right, exactly. It's just RNG, yeah. Anyway, so I was thinking, what I was gonna say about this. I think I mentioned the one shadow, two shadow thing before, right? For the thing that I had such trouble translating. I guess this is a similar logic. So I was wondering why he was putting a blurry, like, lighter color into the hair where I would have expected the highlight to go in. And it's that, it's like, I don't know, I guess it's like diffuse light, right? But the idea is that he laid that down first, and then he's putting a sharp highlight under it. So when you do that with, like, in like VFX, right, that can kind of make the hard light thing that you're making, like, look like it's glowing. I know the way that they do it is they'll take, like, the original object, and then they'll, like, or whatever's supposed to be glowing, and then they'll kind of apply like a filter on it to make it blur outwards a little bit, and then they'll just copy the same object on top of it so that way you see the distinct boundaries of the object, but it also looks like it's glowing because of that diffuse light. So that's what he's doing here. Okay. That makes more sense. Okay, so he's just labeling in red the like the kind of the ring around which the highlight would usually get applied. Yeah. Wonder if he's just gonna manually do it. I mean, as opposed to making like layer mask or something. Tsuya beta, I don't know what that means, but. Oh crap. Okay. And then obviously the further you get from the light source, the less you'd get that reflection, right? So yeah. Okay. And then again, since this drawing does look like it's being illuminated from the rear, he's extending the edge of the highlight, very far up and down the hair. I guess that's not really super relevant to what I'm doing, but yeah. And I guess he also doesn't hesitate to just go over the line art, like just cover the line art with the highlights. So I guess, yeah.
So we'll... I can't see what he's doing. I guess he's just repeating himself. He's just saying, you know, if you wanna put like really strong, like big highlights in, make sure to make the shadows also really like, or make sure to like put a decent amount in, I guess is his point. Wow. Okay, I see. So I guess that's why he made such a big deal about, you know, making sure to put shadows in where, or, you know, well, as much as possible. Wow, that's great. Okay. Oh wait, he fussed with some layer settings there. What was that? What setting is that? I know he's. I'm pretty sure this is Clip Studio. Let me see. So, what is he using? I can't, it's too blurry. Whatever. He has another video, and I'm sure it'll at least be easier to see there. Okay. Sorry, I think he actually said the words here. So, is that? Kurisuta oiage. Is it oiage? Oi. I can't read it. Oiage? Oh, let me just look up hakko. I cannot hear what he's saying or what he's supposed to say. Or what he's. Hakkore ya oiage? Is it oyake? Oh, he says you can alternatively use overlay or soft light to. Yeah. It's probably one of those. But well, yeah, that changes a lot. Yeah, Chegg. Dude, Chegg, I already gave you $15. Shut up. Jeez. You'd think that they'd try to not piss off people that actually gave him some money. これ結局どうなるんだ？手間からと飯からって何なんだろう。I'll look that up later. なんか突然喋り方がうざくなった まあ。逆光ね、はい。ぶっちゃけ使いすぎな気がするけど。Okay. He's summarizing it, but you know, okay, I think that's good. Let's go back to this main tutorial that he has then. I have no idea where that main tutorial was. I think it's in this playlist. Okay, cool. So we're gonna follow his how to make your or how to color hair in an hour tutorial. Of course, that's not literal, but you know, it's also not a 1 hour video, but the idea is that it's simple enough that someone could feasibly do it in an hour. So let's put my iPad and hook it up to the main monitor, or hook it up to the computer. Yeah. Here we go. Okay. Okay, so step one, decide where the light is. I should do. I also have no freaking clue. I think it's just right up top in the from the middle. Although, just for reference, let's also how do other people do it? This is right above, right up top. I just don't know where exactly people usually position the. There's no clear indication of where the shot or where the light source is in this case. Let's. Who else has a really good design? Just for purely from a design perspective. How about. From the top. Oh, no, that's not official art. There's concept art. Yeah, just from the top sounds right. So. Okay. Somewhere around there. I'm just gonna say it's somewhere around there. I'm trying to draw an arrow, but okay, so just very roughly put in where all the shadows would be. I have no idea how I'm gonna do with that. Let's do it like this then. I don't know how exactly, but we're gonna do this. But let's apply it first, and then we'll go into each layer, and then kind of do it to match it. Yeah, I'm gonna roughly putting it in. Just roughly putting it in. Let's see. So. Yeah, where would the hair? Where would the shadows come in? I mean, you'd expect it to be all. I don't know. How do other people do it? Like, what I see a lot of people is it's gonna nudge the bottom edge a bit, right? Here especially. Oh, Konosuba, the study. I should be studying, yeah. Oops. Okay. Again, the point of this isn't to do a lot, it's just to roughly do it. So, like, we want, probably want, like, this entire thing to be, like, whoosh. Right? Like, probably also want, like, this entire part. I think it's more like just in here. How does that look if I just unshade it? Or どうなんだろう? I shouldn't have done such a convoluted hairstyle. Yeah. Well, okay, so what does he do with that? Okay. Yeah, so he's gonna test the opacity later. Yeah, so then I think actually then I guess really what I should just do is go layer by layer really. Crap, this is gonna be a lot of okay, let's start. This entire thing, right? So what do we want to do? I guess we want new layer. And I believe you can use like there's an option somewhere, like clip. Yeah, sorry, I need the I need the Clip Studio documentation. clipping mask. Layer, new raster layer, stack mortars, layer, yeah. Layer clip at layer below. Okay. Clip at layer. I don't. Where is clip at layer below? Like, I know how to do, I know that this works. I've literally made a clipping mask. Where is transfer to lower layer, merge with layer, merge visible, convert layer selection from layer, layer settings. That's just a, oh wait, is it one of these options here? No. Where is it? I think it's this option. Let me test it out. Yeah, okay, that's what, label the damn thing, please. Okay, so it's this thing that I'm clicking in on the, it's right under the word normal for the, where it lists the layer type. Come on. Or at least update, I mean, I guess the, oh, you know what? I was looking for an option, but actually in the documentation, they only show you click a button as well. Not to mention the button doesn't look really like what it looks like now. I wish they would update the documentation a little, but whatever. See, my drawings are just splotchy clumps of hair, so I don't have this issue. Well, if you ever update your, I guess your drawings, then you'll know how to make this, you'll be able to make a layer mask. Okay, so I guess really, where would the shadow be? I guess it's coming from the top, right? So it'd be like this, right? That, I don't know. I know he said not to put it in very like, or not to fuss about the big details here, but I feel like I kind of have to. Alright, we'll change them later, so it doesn't really matter. Okay. Yeah, all of this should just be in a shadow, except for maybe like right here. In which case, I guess I should go back to this layer and be like, more like that, really. And this should just all be shadows. Yeah. Yeah, so much for not fussing about the little details. Yeah, whatever, we'll figure it out later. I think that looks right. So maybe fundamentally I just don't have much to do for this one. At least not for the front of the hair. I guess I just don't have much to do for this, so probably doesn't need any. 顔周り暗くするのちょっと嫌だからな。What was that? I don't think that works well. What is this? Under hair thing. Under a hair thing. I don't know what it is. Well, 2 hours, or 20 hours, 7 seconds. Jeez. Yeah, I don't think that's going to repeat for a while. Yeah, what is... Man, I really have no idea what that layer is supposed to do. Outer right front. It's something that comes. Okay. That's what it is. It's this part, isn't it? More variety than your local state. That's probably true, considering how often you hear stuff repeat. Granted, I haven't listened to the radio in a while, so, you know, who knows, maybe they've upped their game. My emotes are looking sad compared to your drawing. Well, I mean, it's not really fair to compare them, right? I mean, how long did you take to make them, right? And I think they look good. I mean, you know, like, suppose you put this much effort into, like, an emote. Like, all the quality is going to get... the quality is just going to get, like, crushed in, like, you know, the compression process, so... Yeah. And I feel like the main takeaway from this is that, like, it's not actually that... Oh, what? What layer are all these on? What? Yeah, so why? Oh, it is. It is doing the right thing. Okay. I was just gonna say, you know, like, I feel like the takeaway from this isn't that, you know, this drawing is good, and it's more that the amount of the barrier to getting a drawing to look, like, decent isn't that unachievable, you know what I mean? Like, is it time consuming? Yeah, but, like, the barrier doesn't seem to be like some kind of, you know, or to get it to look like decent, you don't need to be like super good. You just need to watch some tutorials and then just have the asinine amount of time you need to actually implement what the tutorials say to do, which I think can't be said for a lot of things, but at least in this case, I think it can be said for at least drawing at this level. So I guess they also need a subscription to Clip Studio Paint or something, if otherwise you'd have to translate all the tutorials to like Photoshop or whatever, but which is, you know, another little bit of a barrier to entry. But like, you know, like if I can do it in, you know, this amount of time, then, you know, and like I honestly think that's a good thing, right? Because if drawing to like a certain this degree of, I guess, competence is easy, then, or if it weren't easy, then I would have no hope of accomplishing everything I wanted to do for, you know, Operation Meet YAGOO, right? So the fact that it's being achieved in a sensible time frame, I think, is a good indication that I might be able to get at least a decent amount of stuff done. By the way, if someone wants to, I probably shouldn't ask that, but I was going to say, if someone wants to make clothes for this model, I'm totally willing to publish the both a PSD and whatever the Clip Studio Paint file is. I mean, you don't even need to have to make the clothes, I'm just saying, you know. Because there's no, like, novel skill or anything involved with making this, so. Wait, what? Oh, okay, there it goes. Yeah, okay, it is that thing, okay. I was fairly sure I knew what that layer did, but it was like, wait, no, it's not working. Just the... It was just the color from the background was the same as the foreground, so even when I hid this layer, it didn't look like it did anything. Yeah. There we go. Of course, I have to go through every layer later and just adjust the shadow, so that's going to be a nightmare of a process, but, you know, we're going to hang in there. Okay, this, I think, should all be dark. my iPad is slowly but surely having trouble with handling the load of running Clip Studio Paint. Oops. Actually, wait, let's not do it like that. Oh, I did that a little weird there, didn't I? Oh, whatever, we'll leave it like that. Actually, wait, I'm missing something. It is on this layer, okay. The way I set up the layers is coming around to bite me in the ass now. I don't know if that makes sense. Check Discord, I was bored. How do I, which account do I have Discord on? I need a dedicated Discord. I need anyway. No, Discord needs to let you have multiple profiles. That's what it needs. Sorry, let me disconnect this real quick. And it's 9:40, it's a good time to take a break. Let's see. Oh, I see a couple of Discord messages. Or Oh man, I'm getting memes. I'm getting memes. Yeah, I guess apparently I have an 11 out of 10 voice. Yeah, although I guess that drawing is going to become wrong as soon as the new update kicks in, right? Because my hair won't be green anymore. It'll be sort of green, right? I tried to keep some green in it, but... Yeah. Yeah, you'll find an ideal... Wait, I thought... Oh, whatever. Yeah. Ideal GF, right? Yeah, sure. Yeah, that's why it's called anime, not real life. That being said, I don't know. It seems kind of blotchy. There's a little more depth that, you know, we were looking for before, but literally choke on my ice. Like, if I don't put that on my, if I don't put you know, that somewhere on my profile, if I ever make a, you know, character profile thing, I think people are gonna get pissed. Like, false advertisement. Like, what do you mean you don't like? The thing is, I do like mint chocolate chips. So, yeah. Although, I don't know. Is there a rear right? What is this layer? Oh, it's all that stuff back there. Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna have to say I do like, you know, mint chocolate chips, so it won't be a lie, or I won't be lying or anything. Oh, this is the difficult to categorize layer. We're leaving it alone. Right, so the neck, something I wanted to do was, this is, what should I call it? I shouldn't call it shadow. I should call it like auxiliary shadow or something. I don't know. Where is this color? I don't remember. There we go. Yeah, I do appreciate the memes, though. Yeah. Yeah, so this one? Just a minute. Kore doko? Oh, this is the edge piece. Okay. So, I'm gonna take this. Oops. Did it twice. You know, I was meaning to say this to another person. As well, but like, you know, it's okay to the thing reminded me, the meme kind of reminded me, like, you know, there's nothing wrong with you know, having fun. I guess is my point. Yeah, I don't know, it's like, you know, like, as much as I mean I don't feel like I'm complaining about them, but I guess in some respects I am complaining about my neighbors that are, you know, partying all the time and stuff, and it's like, you know, like, I joke about it, but I'm not really like looking down on them for, it's not like I'm looking down on them for partying or anything, you know. It's okay to, you know, kick back and stuff. And I guess no one was really saying you shouldn't, but rather just sometimes it feels like some people are like, Like, it's not, I don't, you know, party not because I don't think partying is good. It's just, I don't have time, so. But for people that do, you know, it's totally okay too, right? There's nothing wrong with that. So I guess, you know, I guess this is what I'm gonna do. Oop, not that. I don't know. Any new tunes? Okay, awesome, awesome. I'll listen to them, or I'll tune into the radio and hopefully I'll get one of the new ones. Let's see. どうしようかな? I'll leave that alone. I have no idea how to do this. That Python script. Oh, the one that. Oh, right, right. The one that you mentioned before, right? Yeah. Can't wait for the wave of people late 1 hour for tomorrow, for school tomorrow due to. Well, that way, that switch happened today, though, right? So I assume they would have noticed by now, right? Or wait, is it tonight? Or I thought it was. I'm pretty sure it was today, right? Because I have some clocks that are that I still haven't fixed that are 1 hour off. It was today, right? Yeah. Okay. And I've made so many layers for the hair. I don't know what to do all this stuff anymore. Okay, pause and just think. I mean, granted, everyone says the hair is the hard part all the time, so. What happens if I do this? Oh, it only targets the layer immediately below. Okay. So that's not gonna work. Way better than doing it from scratch. Okay. Yeah, right, the playlist, right? Yeah. That's good. That's good. Yeah, don't yeah, totally don't do it from scratch, yeah. Okay. I think we're gonna manually go through and just do it by gut. So before we do that, we're gonna. And go back and do all our lines in the right shade. Oh, you know, that's a little bit of a problem. Shit. We're gonna ignore that. That's technically a problematic thing, but okay. That doesn't need any shading. We're gonna leave that alone. Yeah. We're gonna ignore that first and that. Straight the hair. Okay, so or do I need to insist on all this now? Yeah, iPad's getting way laggier. I'm sorry, what is this? Kind of happy with this Vim setup. Is everything I need without being too complicated? Honestly, not sure what's going on. I see, But cool. Yeah. Just the coding environment. Okay. It's nice on the eyes, that's for sure. But that's good. That's good. You found something. Yeah. Ow. Oops. Oh, it's not. Yeah. Well, speaking of coding, I gotta refresh my coding skills a little bit. What is this piece? Oh, I'm not even in the right spot, are I? It's probably over here somewhere. There we go. Oh, that's messed up.
I was gonna shade.
Okay, wait, let's go back. Oh, I skipped something. Oh, that. Yeah, we're leaving that alone. Actually, as long as we're here. まあ一旦やるか。
I buffering so much? Oh, it's the audio. What is this? Sitting in U.S. history for past 3 hours and so many. You have class right now? Or starting from, like, I don't know when it started, but, like, now? No, just studying? Okay. Okay, Hitler speeches. I've never listened to a single Hitler speech. Oh, no. Wait, I've listened to, you know that movie when, like, it's like Hitler and, like, all his, like, close aides in, like, a bunker, and they're talking about some plan, and then at some point he just, like, you know, tells everyone to leave the room, and then he starts, like, shouting. I know that's not a speech, but I've seen those memes a lot. I've definitely seen those memes. I don't know what movie they come from, but. Yeah, you know, I think I should have used layer masks, because that would have been a lot more straightforward. Dense watercolor. All right, there's a dense watercolor tool, isn't there? どこ入れたんだ? Oh, it's weird. I'm glad I left that GitHub repo of my translation open, because there's some notes that I left in it that I kind of forgot I didn't actually write down. For hair. Oh, I guess I never clarified. Ugh, oh well. Hmm.
Kaz, welcome back. My first class for the semester starts in 7 hours. I think you need to go to sleep, dude. But yeah, good luck with class. Yeah, good luck. That's all I can really say. Yeah, good luck. I'm afraid of what? I mean, realistically, day one's just gonna be reading the syllabus, right? I don't see what the problem is or what the concern is. I mean, then again, I suppose it's not fair for me to say because I've never really taken a lot of time off from school. Oh no, I guess I took half a year off in back in high school, but that didn't really, yeah. That wasn't really like a oh, it's a vacation thing. It was more like a or it wasn't like a I didn't go to school. It was more like I was on extended leave for whatever reason. So I didn't really feel like I was gone from school that all that much. So I guess that's probably not a fair comparison. Yeah, I'm sure the teacher won't bite. Probably. Why is it on multi-select now? No, I'm done selecting stuff. I just want to draw on the friggin' layer. Stop. Stop selecting multiple things. Oh, that's how you see it. Okay. Right. Let me look it up. Let's see. Hope my teacher didn't ask to turn on the camera. You can't just say yours is broken or something. I mean, you know, if possible, you just you know, you Okay, seriously, Clip Studio, what is going on here? I just want to select one. I just want to select stuff. Please don't make this any harder than it needs to be. Oh, there. Oh, you know what? I bet my headphone was stuck on a button or something, or like shift or something. That's probably what it was. Yeah. I mean, again, ideally, you actually like, you know, show yourself on screen, but you know, if you don't have a webcam or something, then. Honestly, not sure what to do. I turn on my character to the class though. Yeah, letters of rec, right? Yeah, that's true. Yeah. In that sense, I should probably turn on my cameras more too and stuff, but yeah. I don't know, just this semester I've been really lazy, so I'm really demotivated to like do stuff like that, so. Yeah. Sorry, I kind of have to think, what am I going to do here, because... I might just like take all the layers that I have because they're all super separated, which makes it kind of hard to deal with them, but I might just take all the layers I have and just collapse them into the ones that I'll eventually throw into cubism. And then I might put the final colors in, which is kind of redundant because I need them separated so that I can, you know, do modifications later on. But first class is math, then I have fitness life. Fitness life. Well... Well, that's good. Yeah. You want to stay fit. Yeah. Hopefully it's a good class. And, you know, whatever it takes to be a full-time student, right? Like, sometimes you just, you know, want enough classes to be full-time, really. Certainly not going to argue against that. Syllabus for classes, supervised workout routine. Interesting. Well, looks like you can't get out of not having a. Or, yeah, I guess you won't be able to, you know, get away with leaving your camera off then. Yeah, sounds like you're fucked. Yeah, just suck it up and turn on the camera, dude. Like, you know. Yeah, I don't think my iPad's gonna be able to handle, or is kind of keeping up with this anymore. It's getting laggier. Significantly laggier. Watch some K-pop fan cam. What is a fan cam video? Record one member of the group in stage. Okay. Not really sure what that's supposed to accomplish, but. You know, I'm starting to see why. I saw a lot of videos, people were taking, like, when they're making, like, models for, or when they're converting models to be made for, or into ones that were for cubism. They essentially took their art and then they cut it up a bunch, and I was wondering why they did that. Yeah, it's because if you do it by layer, non-destructively, then it takes just an absurd amount of layers to accomplish the same job. Yeah, that's why. I don't know, should I do that too? なんか物足りたい、物足りないんだよな。しっかりしてるんだよな。ああ、でも結構そのままなんだね。Like, this does work. Okay, whatever. Okay, see, that looks a little... Okay, so we just... Okay, so now that we have that in place, we can kind of fix the shadows. Yeah, let's start with the fix. Let's set the highlights. Maybe that's the step I need to take. It's supposed to look like that overall. Yeah. Okay. Nemo. Oh, that's what it's doing. Whatever, we'll leave it alone. Oh, the biter is when playing Victoria, your resource hand them over. And I'm over. At gunpoint. Maybe not. I don't know. Okay. So that looks better. I think. I think I need to watch the full video again. It's like, are we the bad guys? It's like, wait, I've seen this in movies before. Are we the bad guys?
Okay. そんなに印象の足しにならないんだけどな。Let's see, to quote a video, naturally the engineer units the indigenous population. It's a faster gear production. Well, I guess it's role playing, right? Yeah, we'll leave it at that. Okay, so
っぱり中心まで来る線を増やすとかっていう。うん、やっぱ影で表現するか。Oh, I'm using... Yeah, that's why. Yeah, I guess doing it like that makes it a little bit more natural. あ、これ追加されてんの。Luna Matsuri collab in an hour? Shit, I was gonna go to sleep. I guess I'm staying up. Well, I can sleep to it. Yeah, I can sleep to it. Yeah. I mean, what kind of Matsurisu would I be with if I were to, you know, succumb to sleep? I mean, a responsible one, but like, you know, fuck that, right? Nanora. I really do like the pairing though. It's a good they're a good it's a good collab pairing. Okay, yeah, so that's the kind of the thing I want going on with this. Okay. Maybe it's more of an arc, so.
Okay.
Doesn't make it better. So, I totally underestimated how long it would take to finish the hair. I mean, I guess it's less that I underestimated and more that I was wishfully hoping that it wouldn't take this long. But, same difference. Yeah, so these two layers could be combined, though. So all that texture can go on one layer. Problem is, how do I duplicate this diffuse light layer?
Why does it look different? Oh, there is a lighter one. Okay. ああ、もう全部一からしようかな。
No, it should be. Yeah, yeah. Let's go with this. Okay. awfully red. Oh, what is this? Checking language exchange subreddit. Okay. For X language, for language, big. For X language, my friendship. well, you know. I hope he gets some offers. It sounds like he's, sounds like he's motivated, that's for sure. Almost always English to Mandarin or English to Spanish. Wait, so how does it work? I haven't used it before, so does it mean like you want some text converted, or like is it supposed to be like language practice, or? You just talk to each other in the target language you're learning. Okay. In Spanish, so you can practice and talk to me in English for the same purpose. Okay. 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 Well, that's nice. That's cool that there's a. community for that. Okay, so it might look like I didn't make any progress, because I didn't, but I think I've got a strat. I'm going to go with this style, because I think it gives me the kind of the, it makes the hair up here interesting enough, and I've got a plan. It's going to be use whatever this color is I have selected right now as the primary, like, shadow color. Then we do the big shadows area and, like, these little text, you know, just to kind of show the hair has some stuff going on there. And then we're going to use the airbrush and just use the transparent color and just airbrush the little bits that need to be lightened. And then I'm trying to think what else I need. And mainly I'm saying this so I can go back to the VOD and, like, double check what I was even thinking, but right, I think this is the strat. I think this is the strat, at least this time around. I don't know, actually. Either way, it's almost midnight. I think I should just go to sleep, and then maybe I'll spend some time tomorrow on it. What do I even have tomorrow? Quick, let's use our secret move. Blur the entire screen. Oh, I see that one's unaligned, so I'll fix the alignment on that scene later. Just office hours, yeah. So if I can kick myself awake, then I'll. Actually, no. I'm gonna go sign up for a COVID appointment, or, you know, the twice a week ones that you have to do, and I'll set that for sometime in the morning so that I have to wake up. Tomorrow's already the 15th. Scary. Thank you. Well, so I just have to load that tomorrow, and I can go to my appointment. Okay. It's missing. This drawing's missing something. I think it's that this is too. There's too much going on here, I think. I want to keep something like this here just so that the top isn't just a blank slate kind of thing. But this is too much going on. I think that's problem one. And then problem two is that because I made that like that, I made this like this, but I don't really want it like this. I think I want it to transition more gradually as it goes down. But then I also want it to become lighter right at the eyes. So, yeah. So that's going to be the plan. Then I think I could use some of these colors more liberally. Excuse me. Yeah. I think I need an in-between color in these brown areas. Like, I don't know if I want that, but maybe more like that. I could offer Spanish, but I don't know why I'm so bad at me because I use slangs when I speak. Well, yeah, I guess that kind of depends on what kind of, you know, what of that language you're trying to learn, right? Because if you're trying to learn, like, just how people speak, then, yeah, slang, in fact, probably would help because it kind of, it makes sure your vocab is in line with what people expect. On the other hand, if you're trying to learn it formally, then I bet slang could kind of get in the way, so. Yeah, so you'd have to double-check that with, anyone you get matched up with or whatever, wouldn't you? Yeah. Yeah. Okay. I think this is going to be the strat, though. I think this is the strat. Hmm. British English and Japanese. Interesting. Like the British accent. Okay. All right. I mean, that makes sense. Yeah. Yeah, I need to think about what I'm going to do with the hair a little bit. I might, you know, actually I have an idea. Deep Blizzard had, in his tutorial, he mentioned a specific brush that he downloaded. I think I might download that. All right. Well, anyway, yeah, so I'm going to call it a day today. So Kaz, Konosuba, probably, what, like Skullmeat? Probably about that area. Thanks for staying till the end. And again, if there's anyone else that stayed till the end, thank you. Of course, the stream manager doesn't really give me an accurate idea of how many people are here, so it's hard to gauge. So I kind of have to go by who commented. But yeah, so everyone, thanks for staying till the end. Take care, stay safe, have a good evening. You know, for people in the US, watch out for, you know, daylight savings time. Or are we out or in daylight savings time? I guess we're out of it, right? We're in? Man, I'm so confused. We're in it. Okay. We're in daylight savings time then, I guess. Okay, so for everyone that's in the US, watch out and make sure you're not late to work or something. But yeah, thanks for staying until the end. Take care, stay safe, have a good evening. お疲れ、おやすみ、終わり。